There are so many opportunities awaiting you through Missouri Renewable Energy, a division of the New Life Evangelistic Center. During this program, we're going to feature one man and what he is doing with the inspiration he's gotten from Missouri Renewable Energy, the solar panels he's received, and much more. So be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice. During this program, Jeff Schneider is going to be following Joe Anthony, and Joe's going to take you through a step-by-step procedure, all the way from how he actually acquired the metal to build a solar tracker, on how he made a solar cooker, and then how does the tracker, the cooker, and the solar panels all work together. You won't want to miss this very special program as we take you through step-by-step and show you how one man, by being inspired and utilizing the tools that are available to him, actually produced energy-saving devices, actually saving not only money on his utility bills, but also discovering the joy that comes from learning and utilizing the free gift of the sun. At this time, let's go to Jeff and Joe.
We're here with Joe Anthony today, talking about a unique project, Joe, that you're doing, and that's a do-it-yourself homemade solar tracker. Now, folks, you can use this for tracking the sun with your photovoltaic panels. They're very expensive if you buy these retail off the shelf from manufacturers. But Joe's going to talk to us about picking up the parts down here at Shapiro Steel and actually building one of these yourself.
Sure. Well, I got the metal down here at Shapiro's, and I built this tracker. I'd also like to mention, too, that this tracker, you could use it for your water solar collector also to track the sun if you thought that was important.
Now, is that for filtering water?
Or? No, your water heater.
Okay, for solar hot water.
Yeah, okay, it would make it much more efficient if you tracked it, and it wouldn't be that hard to do that either. So anyway, I made the tracker, and this is where I got my metal at, and maybe we can show you some of the metal I got, and then you can take a look at the completed project and see what you think.
Okay, folks, come with us. We're going to go with Joe. We're going to see where we're going to go with parts, pulling them right off the shelf. Then we're going to go with Joe to his house and check out that solar tracker.
This eighth inch by eighth inch by eighth inch angle is my basic truss that I made to hold the panels up. And you'll see that when you look at the completed project. These are arms that I built. The main tube runs down the center. These mount on that tube and hold the panels. So we look for a big tube for the center. I also make this tube rotate so I can actually track different times of the year. In the wintertime, naturally, you need to be lower to the horizon. Summertime, you need to tilt it back. So I made that adjustable in that respect, too. Started off with a piece of tube like this for my main support. With these other eighth-inch pieces, I welded them across this way, and my panels mount on that. This is mounted on a pole, which rotates, and that tracks the sun. And I have a circuit board that follows that. I used a old dish mover, one of those big 10-footers that you can see people give away all the time. There was my actuator. Works perfect. It moves the tracker back and forth. It's 12-volt. I ran it on a little battery, and I got a little trickle charger to keep the battery up. Never had a problem with it. It's been on now for 2 years. So I'm real pleased with that setup.
We're actually going to go back to Joe's house and see one of these solar trackers that you can use for photovoltaics, for solar hot water. It's fantastic. It's a very affordable way to build your own solar tracker, folks. We've seen a few parts here that Joe showed us here at Shapiro Metal that you can pick up off the shelf with scrap metal here laying around. It's probably been here, Joe, like you say, for 20 years, untouched scrap metal that you can pick up. Normally ends up in a landfill, ends up here for the do-it-yourselfer. Love coming down here every Saturday to hear about folks doing their particular project.
I do have one more thing you can use with this solar tracker circuit board is my solar oven also tracks the sun. I don't have to go out and turn my oven to track the sun. This does it for me.
And Joe, we're going to actually see this live. What's the cost that someone can actually put one of these together?
Well, I think my metal cost me right around $150. Then you got to be able to weld it, so you need a welder and know how to do that. Cut metal, so you need some way to cut it. And the circuit board, I think even with shipping, was $64. So it's not bad, and wiring was very small wire. Most people, 14-gauge wire. And I used a little car battery, a little 12-volt battery out of a security panel. And that supplies the power for this thing. So it probably under $200.
Under $200, folks. I've seen solar trackers out there retail for $1,000 and more.
Yes.
This is an affordable way to do it yourself, and it's very effective. Joe, you've done a lot of great projects. Joe's actually worked with some biodiesel equipment and different things, always caught up in the renewable energy self-sufficiency type of projects. Joe, we'd love to see them. And stay tuned, folks. We're going to be going to Joe's house on site and see that solar tracker. Thanks, Joe.
Yes, you're welcome. Thank you.
In a few minutes, Joe is going to actually take us to his home, show us the panels that he got through Missouri Renewable Energy, how he's utilizing those, and then how he's constructing a solar cooker. Ways that he was inspired through Missouri Renewable Energy, whether it's 24.2 or www.moreenergy.org or www.americanrenewableenergy.org, you can receive the same help, the same inspiration. Yes, Missouri Renewable Energy is set up to help you. To help you to not only learn the world of renewable energy, but help you to get solar panels and wind generators at discount prices. Let me give you that number. 314-881-3213. That's 881-3213. Let's go at this time now as Joe and Jeff take a look at the panels that he acquired through Missouri Renewable Energy and also how he's utilizing all of that.
Joe, you have so many exciting projects, self-sufficiency projects that you've completed here and have been very successful. You're tied to the grid for electricity. And folks, we're going to get in with this with Joe. Joe's actually collecting his own water here, your own rainwater. We didn't realize, Joe, when we came out here, there's so many things to talk about. And we're actually seeing your solar array here. You built your own racking system, and it's working great. I just seen it move. You actually built your own tracker for it as well. And folks, trackers are normally very expensive. Joe, you built yours for a couple $100s. And I understand that trackers, at least from my research, 20 to 30% gain in efficiency. That's that much more power. That's a lot of power over a year's time, and especially in the winter time, you really need tracking, if you really want to get the most bang for your buck when you're putting solar together. Joe bought these solar panels from us, Joe, well, we really appreciate the idea of actually coming out here and seeing some panels that we sold you with through Missouri Renewable Energy. You're actually got these babies up. We talked to you today at Shapiro's about Shapiro Steel. You buy some affordable steel. You've put a whole framing system together here for your panels. Tell us a little bit more about this.
This is my system that I came up with. As when we were at Shapiro's, I showed you these 8x8x8 angles. Here they are done. What I did is I welded them to the tube that I showed down at Shapiro's. And you see that by the time they get to the end, they're pushed together. I put little boxes. This is just a 1/2 inch by 1/8 inch strip that I cut up and put them in place. And these all will actually mount the panels with the standard mounting brackets and hardware that comes with the panel, so it lines up real easy that way. As you see, I made 4 trusses because I have 3 rows of panels, so I needed 4 trusses. This tube here will actually rotate. That's what this arm is for. I haven't put the threaded rod between here. If I take these bolts out, I can actually rotate this arm in this bracket to change it for the different angles of the season. I made all this for my rotation, but now that I've looked at it, I think if you went to the junkyard and found an old minivan with drum brakes in the back, cut that drum brake off and the axle that comes with it, you could mount that up here, and that would be your spot where you could put this piece of pipe. It would rotate really nice. I think one of the other advantages could be is it has an emergency brake. You could take the cable and lock this thing down if you're worried about it turning in the wind. I haven't had that problem, but that would be much easier than going through all this welding that I did to make this rotate. This actuator came off of a big dish that people use, and they give them away, actually. I'm running it on 12 volts. It's a DC motor, so it'll be very happy with 12 volts, and you can take it up to 32 on this one. I don't know if you can see it or not, but at the top of my panels, I have a mason jar lid screwed to an L bracket. I have my circuit board inside there screwed to that lid, and I took a mason jar and screwed it down in the lid. So now I have a weatherproof covering for my circuit board, and it can still see the light because it needs to be able to see the sun to know which way to go. For conduit, I used a water pipe that you would use to hook up your ice maker on your refrigerator with the connections, and it worked fine. It's all waterproof, and it's easy to do. So I got four wires running up there for the circuit board, and it comes down to here, and that goes into the motor. So that's basically what I did. I mean, it's I guess if you get it set up and start welding on it, you could go pretty fast. I put rings, pieces of pipe, on my trusses because I wasn't quite sure if I had it perfect. I slid these down until I got them right where I want it, and then ran a bolt through them. So that locked them down. You could just weld it right on if you want. But I was able to make these trusses individually and then slide them on this piece of tube. But this is a grid-tied system, which means that I'm tied into the electrical power that comes into the house. I'm using these microinverters. They're made by Enphase. This one inverter works this one panel. It takes the DC voltage off this panel, converts it to AC right here. I'm sending AC into my house. I'm not sending DC in. I don't have a big inverter down the basement. It's a plus with this. This is actually on my computer. I can actually go to a computer web page and look at this particular panel to see how much this panel's working on and compare it to this one, or if this one's having problems. So that's kind of nice. The system isn't that expensive comparing it to the normal inverter that you take DC into your house and invert it down the basement. It's about the same price. As an electrician, I like it because I don't have to run big cables to the house because I got all this DC power. I'm running AC into the house. It's only a 30-amp circuit. So I ran number 10 wire. It's much easier to run. If you're a business and it's something that you want to do, this also produces three-phase. I didn't hook it up because I don't have three-phase. But this is actually putting out three-phase. So there is a plus to that, too. So I really enjoy those. I think them are the way to go. And so far, I've not had any failures, and it's been working. Oh, this is probably 4 years on these. And I've got some others on the roof that have been at least 6 years, something like that. So I think they're working fine. One of the other advantages to having a microinverter per panel is if you have a DC string, and which means that you have a set of panels and they're all wired one to the next, if you have shade on one end, you knock down the whole system. And I'm sure that everybody's done this. If you had a flashlight and you've only got one brand new battery, and you put the one brand new battery in there, you don't have a good flashlight. The one good battery draws down because the old one. Well, that's the way these systems work on series. So you get shade on one of your panels if you run it in a series DC. It brings the whole system down. This, on the other hand, if shade gets on this one panel and this one panel goes down, it doesn't affect this panel. This panel is still putting out as much as it can put out. So there's a big advantage to having individual inverters because of that one shading problem. On this one here, I can change the angle of my panels to compensate for the sun moving in relationship where we're at. In the wintertime, the sun appears to be lower in the horizon, which means that this panel has to be changed a different degree to look at the sun straight at it. So it's about 10 degrees in the winter versus 10 degrees in the summer. You have to take it past because the sun is much higher in the summertime. So that's what these bolts are. I take these two bolts out. I can rotate this whole panel and get my degree change and then lock it back down. And I was going to put a bolt here to hold it. I haven't done that for this year. I've got holes drilled for the different angles right now. So what I do is get two people out here, we rotate it. I pull these bolts out. I put the bolts back into the new holes, and that's my winter time. And that's what I do to change the angle for summer, winter. Some more information about how I built this. This is a Schedule 40 water pipe, and I found a piece of pipe that this slides into perfectly. So now I have a joint where I can rotate these panels. I put a couple grease fittings in here because this does rotate within this pipe here, so I can change my angle. That was the easiest stuff to get. It worked out fine. As you see inside of here, I guess we'll get some close-ups of that. I used this diameter pipe inside my trusses because then I can make these trusses on the bench without having this whole thing, sitting someplace. Then I just slid this down to where it needed to go in this pipe. Once I got it lined up to the edge of the panel at the right distance, I drilled it and put a bolt in it, and that locked it down. So that's a little bit more. This is an old light pole. It's a square tubing. I did do a little bracing down at the bottom. And at the top here, I made a mount for my actuator to move. I took another piece of this pipe here and welded it to this little bracket here, and that's where I made my mount for my actuator to go on. It also can slide to get it at the right place for this to be working. This actuator has stops in it where it can only go so far before it shuts electric off, and so far the other way. You must have that, because if you don't have that, there's a chance that this thing would just keep on going and this motor would burn up on you. So you definitely need your stops in here. And the grease fittings, therefore, keeping this greased inside here, because like I say, this tube rotates inside of this one. And if I could do it, you know, these bolts here, this would move this panel. It would change the angle. So I wanted to grease it up because this is never coming apart again as far as I'm concerned. And that's why I put grease fittings in it.
Well, Joe got his panels through Missouri Renewable Energy. And again, if you need help and you want to get some panels and you want to discover the very best when it comes to pricing and even get the 10% discount as you become a member of Missouri Renewable Energy, go to give them a call at 881-3213. That's 881-3213. We want to encourage you at this time in every way possible. Joe also received some plans that he used for his oven through Missouri Renewable Energy and American Renewable Energy. Yes, at American Renewable Energy site, get the same programming that individuals get at 24.2, over 500 shows in the field of renewable energy. So we're going to continue to move forward as Joe takes you through a step-by-step procedure, showing you now the oven that he built. So let's go to Jeff and Joe.
This is my solar oven. I've got a lot of ideas from Reverend Rice's website, and I decided to build one. This guy here rotates, as you see. And my solar tracker that I'm using for my solar panels will do this tracking for me also. So this baby will actually track the sun and keep your temperature way up without having to come out and work on it to make it move. It's very easy circuit. The parts weren't very expensive. Naturally, this thing, some people say I went overboard on building it, but if you make any kind of tracker, I used a Lazy Susan bearing assembly. You can get to a wood shop, they have them, and that's why this thing moves so easy. So that's how this thing rotates. You can put your tracker on that and then put your motor on it, and you'll be able to track the sun. I use a solar panel to charge the battery, so this thing is independent. It'll keep going on itself. This is double thermal glass, and it's siliconed in between. I tried to seal it as best I could. I left the air gap so the gases can get out of it. It's not very sunny today. We had a lot of clouds, but it is 150 degrees in there. And this one here has a plate inside. I guess you can't see it. It's painted black. In back of that is the rest of this housing. So my idea was that it's actually a chute that the heat would transfer. In other words, the heat comes on this black panel, rises, goes up here. When the cold air drops, it drops in back of this panel, under in back of it, and then comes back out here and starts the process again. I thought I could keep more heat in by doing that, by having this circulating system. And it seems to work okay. So that's my solar cooker.
Isn't that exciting how it all works together? How you put a solar tracker together, then that works the panel, that works the oven? Well, that and many other ideas are awaiting you at www.moreenergy.org, where you'll learn about all the latest energy shows, and you can come and share your experiences as to what you're doing with other people. That's a great opportunity for you. And then in addition to that, remember the programming at www.americanrenewableenergy.org and at 24.2. Well, if you have ideas, why don't you contact us so Jeff and other staff can come out and show what you're doing in the same way we're doing concerning Joe. And again, you can contact us at 314-421-3020, or you can call directly the Moore office, where you can also learn about the solar panels and different things that you can do. Well, share what you are doing and also get some ideas by calling 314-881-3213. That's 881-3213. Well, we're going to go back to Joe at this time as he shows us the circuit board that controls the solar panel and where you can actually purchase that for as little as $35.
You are probably one of the most self-sufficient people we've ever interviewed, and just an amazing things that you're doing here with the chicken coop, with the solar. As far as the solar tracker, you've figured out a way to do it affordably. We've seen that. It's incredible. Tell us, if someone wants to build one of these solar trackers affordably, $200 or less, where they're up to thousands of dollars, I've seen them on the internet and retail. You can build one of these yourself. Tell us how to actually get started and do that.
All right. What I did was I went to this company at Red Rock Energy, and we have a website for you to go to. I bought his circuit board, and it's $35. This little circuit board is the brains to move that actuator, and it tracks the sun all day long for you. This board here is also smart that at the end of the day, when the sun goes down, it moves back and waits for the sun to come back up on the west, yeah. Or east rather. So that's kind of nice. It parks itself ready to go. It don't have to wait for the morning for the sun. It goes all, and then it starts moving. So these boards were $35 a piece. Very reasonable. I don't know how you could even contemplate making one. It's four wires going to it. You have DC power going to it, which is a battery, which I have a little motorcycle battery. And then you got the two wires going out to your actuator. Your actuator sends its DC. If it runs the wrong way, you flip the wires over. And that's all you got to do to make it work. I think I mentioned that I used a mason jar for my enclosure for this particular circuit board.
To keep it waterproof
and to mount it in the sunlight. I took the lid and mounted it to a little L bracket. I put a little straight piece of metal L bracket again. This mounts on it. There's a hole on either side. It mounts on that lid. My wires came in through the lid, and that's how I wired it. When all this was done, I took my mason jar, put over this, screwed it down to my lid. I have a waterproof connection. And I also have this thing looking into sun. So that part was really easy. I'm real pleased with this. I've had this go for 3 years now, I think, and never had a problem except that we had a hailstorm, and the hail hit the glass, broke it. The glass filled up with water, shorted it up. So that was my only problem, and that was just an accident. So I'm real pleased with it.
And folks, if you would like to help build it, or actually start working on building your own solar tracker, go to www.redrock.com. That's www.redrock, just like it sounds, redrock.com. And talk to Dwayne Johnson there and find out how you can start today on building your own affordable sun tracker for solar cookers, solar water heating, and most importantly, as we talk to Joe today, a solar tracker for photovoltaic panels. Thanks very much.
When you start getting involved in Missouri renewable energy, you're going to have an opportunity to learn so many different things. We've just talked a little bit about an oven today and a tracker and solar panel. So many other areas in the field of renewable energy. For example, a hydrogen generator. I want to go back to Joe just for a moment. He also got that idea as he's working with Missouri Renewable Energy, and stay tuned to 24.2 and www.americanrenewableenergy. And he's actually going to show you how he put it on his vehicle. In this case, it's a 1996 Suburban, and he's going to just give you a quick overview on that. There's so much more to learn in that area. That's why you need to stay tuned to 24.2 or www.americanrenewableenergy.org, or come on out to the energy shows. And again, they're all listed for you at www.moreenergy.org. So many things going on in this field of renewable energy. So exciting. So many people trying different things, and we're trying to see what works and what doesn't work. Well, let's go to Joe and Jeff, back to them, as we learn about the hydrogen cell, the hydrogen generator.
This is my hydrogen cell for my 96 Suburban I put it on. This cell here produces 3 liters per minute, a huge amount of fuel or gas, brown gas, for this type of cell. I've tried everything I could to make better mileage on this car, and I cannot get it to do any different than what it is right now. And I really know that it's the computer that's causing it to change constantly. No matter how much extra I give it, it'll change back and it stays at that mileage. I've tried a circuit board to trick the O2 sensors into thinking it was a rich mixture, which or a lean mixture, and that didn't work. So I kind of stopped right here. Getting a computer for this that would be programmable would probably be the ideal thing, but that's my problem with this one right now. So,
well, Joe is doing a lot of experimentation in his garage. He's doing all kinds of experimentation with hydrogen and gas, trying to figure out how to actually run a vehicle on it totally. That and a lot more. And so we'll keep you posted. At the same time, we want to share with the community what you are doing. That's why I encourage you to come on out to the energy shows or give us a call at 314-881-3213. That's 881-3213. And just let us know what you're doing. And also, if you want further information on actually acquiring solar panels or other information, upcoming shows, again, a lot of that's at the website at www.moreenergy.org, but you can give a call and talk to Dave, and he'll go into further information with you. That's 314-881-3213. Missouri Renewable Energy and American Renewable Energy are all a part of the New Life Evangelistic Center, which has on-the-job training programs in the field of renewable energy for individuals that were previously homeless or those wanting to move in the field of renewable energy. And all this is possible because of those of you that are supporting the work of New Life. Your prayers and gifts at this time are very much needed and appreciated, so we can continue to not only keep our programs going, but expand them in many different ways. And so if you haven't yet become a club member, we call it Club 24, it's only $24 a month, 80 cents a day. Well, you can let us know that. We'd be happy to get you involved in that. Or if you have not yet become a member of Missouri Renewable Energy, you definitely need to do that. That's only $8.80 a month, $100 a year, and there's so many benefits. You get discounts on your solar panels and other items that you acquire through Missouri Renewable Energy. In addition to that, you get an opportunity to receive free videos, and they'll explain all that when you call 314-881-3213. These are complete courses in many of these different fields that we're talking about. And you also have a chance to come and get some hands-on experience through a wide variety of classes. So don't miss out now. If you have not yet become a member of Missouri Renewable Energy, you're really missing out on taking a big step into the field of renewable energy. So you need to call now, 314-881-3213. That's 881-3213, and ask about becoming a member of Missouri Renewable Energy. And again, you can go to www.americanrenewableenergy.org or stay tuned to 24.2 if you live in the bi-state area. But start taking those first steps towards energy independence. And let's be earth keepers using the free energy that God has given us rather than earth breakers. I'm Larry Rice for Missouri Renewable Energy.